joining us now via Zoom is Manila Mayor Isko Moreno. Mayor Isko, good morning to you, sir.
Hi, Karen. Good morning sa iyo at sa iyong mga staff dyan, sa agency at sa lahat ng ating mga tagapanood. Magandang
umaga. Magandang umaga sa iyo, Mayor. Let's start with this. You have senators already voicing out their concern against the dumping of white sand in Manila Bay. You already have some lawmakers calling for the project to temporarily be stopped and investigated. Dapat tanungin muna ang lungsod ng Maynila. I know you support the project, but when it comes to the timing and priorities, really it should be stopped first.
Well, what will be major reason to stop, and what are we going to gain when we stop? It's long overdue, Karen. Let's be fair to the environmentalists who fought for this for 20 years, Karen. Nakipaglaban yung mga environmentalists na lilisin ang Manila Bay. Then, fortunately for them, Supreme Court already decided on the matter after so many battles from the lower court to the higher court, requiring all local government unit to act on cleaning up the bay. Now, there must be a valid reason to stop this project. This is a rehabilitation. Let's go back to its principle. No? Baka lang nakakaligtaan natin. This is a rehabilitation of the entire Manila Bay. And you are just talking only of Manila alone. Manila Bay is composed of so many provinces and municipalities and cities. No, this is just the beginning. That's why we're very grateful, Karen. Alam naman natin na napakadumi na natubig ng Manila Bay. At isa dyan, isang sa violator dyan, ay ang siyudad ng Maynila.
Okay.
As you can remember, that's why I closed Manila Zoo, because Manila Zoo is also violative of some provisions of being polluted to Manila Bay.
Okay.
So there must be reasons. And these lawmakers, I understand their feelings. But remember, they were also they're part also of the approval of the 2020 budget last year. And it was presented to them one way or another. Kasi may program naman yan. Third, Karen, timely. Eh, 2 years ago pa ito eh. Hindi naman ito sinimuran ng isang linggo, noong isang buwan, o noong January. This is 2 years ago. So, didn't happen overnight. It's just that your attention or some other individual attentions were called when it is white sand.
Okay.
What if it is black sand?
All right, that's an interesting point. But okay, let's start first. Okay, Mayor, there's a group of fisher folk and environmentalists that have actually released a position paper that claim that this has violated several laws in Manila alone. So I want you to answer these issues. Number one, did the DENR consult with the City of Manila regarding the use of dolomite for Manila Bay? Because the group says it violates the local government code of 1991 if the city was not consulted. Was the city consulted?
Again, Karen, if your question particular only to the sand, we don't ask on what material, what they're going to put. No. There'll be sand. It was proposed to us. We were informed when I assumed my office July 1, 2019, which is a year and a few months ago. end of the project started when President Duterte mm-hmm. put an end to this non-performance or hindi tumutupad sa tungkulin na doon sa Mandamus. And we are very grateful as Manileño. Yeah. I am, not only as mayor. Yeah. I am grateful to DNR because somebody did. No?
Yes.
And so, sinabi sa amin, i-rehabilitate.
Yes.
And it is merong SDP at lalagyan talaga ng sun.
Oo.
Now, what kind of sun? Hindi namin alam. Mm-hmm. Now, then here we are, for some reason, about to finish the project. It's getting good attention, including foreigners. They appreciated the program and the project. Some individual are better than the government. They thought that they're better than the government. Became specialists and experts in protection of environment. Then when they said that Dolomite about Monday, if I'm not mistaken, na ito raw ay makapaminsala. O, edi sabi ko, nung ako'y tinanong ng ABS-CBN nga, sabi ko, well, I am no expert. I am no scientist. But I think the right agency to be asked is DNR. And I think DNR, in its right mind, na itinalaga ng batas na magpuproteksyon sa kapaligiran, ay siyang dudumi ng kapaligiran.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense.
Okay,
then
quickly.
I said, Mayor, sabi ko, kung yan ay makapaminsala at mapapatunayan ng mga scientific, paresto ko sila lahat.
Okay, but, quickly. Mayor, yeah. Mayor, I have a few questions, eh. So I wanna quickly lang. So, this, just a clarification. Under the law, this does not need the approval of the Sangguniang Bayan ng Maynila. The reason I'm asking this is if it's perceived as shortcuts in the city of Manila, it might be halted by court cases or a temporary restraining order. So this does not need the approval of the Sangguniang.
No, dahil Karen, you know, the mere fact that it's been ongoing for the past 2 years, the last council already agreed on it.
Okay. Number two, the issue of these environmental groups that came out with this position paper is there is no environmental compliance certificate that it's actually safe to use this dolomite material in Manila Bay. And the DENR said you don't need to use the EIS system. But I'm curious, what are the rules in Manila? Do you ask for an environmental impact assessment? Or you just went on complete trust with the DENR?
Of course, you have to trust the government. Whom do you trust? Sino pang hindi natin pagkakatiwalaan ko yung pamalaang katulad dito yung nangangalaga ng kapaligiran gumagawa ng isang proyekto after so many years and decades, no, of build, now it's being addressed.
Yeah.
Yeah. So their opinion is as good as mine. Yeah. What matter most, ito na tayo, let's cut the long story short, Karen, and let's be straightforward. Why did they, ba't sila lumabas? Sabi nila, ano raw, makapabisala, tapos na kagabi. Ito, Karen, tapos na kagabi.
Okay, can we show that?
No,
okay.
But let me confront and straightforward answer. Ang dolomite makapaminsala? Ang sabi, hindi. Sino may sabi? Hindi po ako, hindi rin DNR, DOH, Department of Health. So what's the next issue? For them. Yun lang sa atin. Tapos ako, naniniwala ako, nagpapasalamat ako bilang Manileño, bilang batang Maynila, that someday, somehow, liliwanag, lilinis ang tubig, no, ng Manila Bay. And I'm grateful to it.
Okay.
Bilang Manileño.
Yes. I read that statement of the DOH, and you can put the statement up, Mayor. That statement essentially clarifies that dolomite is not a health hazard, but the DOH stood by their earlier statement that the dolomite dust, can cause health problems.
Yes.
Because technically,
nobody denies that.
Yeah.
When it's dust, it's like pulpo.
Boo.
Remember, 5 microns, 10 microns against 2,000, 25 millimeter.
Mm-mm.
Is that's 100 times bigger, so it won't suspend in the air.
So you are secure.
So the same thing with Monaco. When you're in Monaco, you see dolomite in their beaches. That is a man-made beach.
Yeah.
You can see it in Plantation Bay, in Sheraton Hotel, and other beaches, man-made beaches in the world. It's being utilized.
Mm-hmm.
We've never heard that a dolomite with such size is harmful to those who will... At saka kailangan pala, narin, ulitin ko lang, walang ginagawang beach. Dati na pong may beach dyan, nung lumang panahon. Oh, wala pong ginagawang bagong beach. It's just that through the years, by natural accretion and force accretion and negligence, nagkabulok-bulok yung Manila Beach.
Okay.
But it's an old beach front.
Yes, I agree with you there. Professor Mahar Lagmay, actually, on ANC, said technically there is nothing wrong with putting dolomite in certain beaches because he calls this beach beautification. It's done when to increase or protect the price of real estate property. And you're right, you've mentioned it in several resorts in the Philippines. Tama kayo doon, Mayor. Pero ang tanong is, Professor Lagmay said this will be expensive, that every so often you will have to put dolomite again, every so often, maybe a couple of years after, so to sustain the white sand feel of the area. Sino po gagastos noon, Mayor? Will the City of Manila spend for the maintenance of that?
I may agree with the doctor, no? Na baka sakali na maubos lang yan pagka hinampas ng dagat. But we were told that there are engineering works or measures that they put to protect the sand, not to be washed away all the way to the Salaot, no? So second, no, kung sakali maluwag ang pera namin pagdating ng araw, 10 years from now, 5 years from now, just to give an opportunity to anybody to have a beach feel and a vibrancy in the city, and it will attract businesses, tourists, for our hotels in Bay Area,
yeah,
and restaurants, I will do so. But not, I agree with some, don't get me wrong, but not in this pandemic. I will continue to spend every single cent that is available for this pandemic. But again, this thing, the project itself, if some politicians, which I've been seeing, utilizing, making it appear that they are pro-poor, sana bigas na lang ang binigay, kaysa pangit, they are not making sense. They know very well that it was done 2 years ago. 2 years ago, nobody talked about it. Now it's about to be finished and we're very happy. It's going to address a particular important matter. And the sand is just another thing, no? So again, if that will add up, Karen, I will push for it kung ito'y makatutulong sa turismo at negosyo. But it is not my priority. I am not going to spend it any single cent today. Hanggat may pandemic, I will buy remdesivir, I will buy equipment, I will buy anything that will help a patient who got infected in coronavirus.
Okay. All right. I see where, as a mayor, I understand your concern that clearly it will look more beautiful. It can even encourage or attract more businesses and tourists.
And jobs.
And jobs in the area, okay. And it seems you have a vision You've cited several other countries that use dolomite. Okay. Now, my question is, there's a study of the National Mapping and Resource Info Authority that, number one, sea level in Manila Bay is rising 4 times faster than the global average. So that's one. Number two, there are a lot of fish pens in Manila Bay. Moving it, labas natin, Mayor, right outside.
Thank you.
Okay, let's discuss that.
Let's discuss that.
Yes, because if we talk about resorts, let's talk about Shangri-La. Wala naman pong basura na pumapasok sa Shangri-La in Cebu. Or wala naman pong fish pens anywhere near. So, you know, when they manage the sand, I mean, they must be spending a lot, but I can imagine our resorts are able to manage it. But I'm thinking the problem that you have of trash getting washed in the bay. What do you do with that, Mayor? And you have illegal fish pens. Illegal fish pens.
Yeah, that is a very good point. Of all the questions this morning, kasi yung paglilinis ngayon, nung rehabilitation ngayon ng Manila Bay, naalala mo sinabi ko kanina, it's just one of many.
Yeah.
That's why it's a good question to our viewers. Hopefully, if all the attentions of your mayors, of your governors in your respective provinces, you demand also to follow and heed the call of the Supreme Court in the Matamos case. Kasi tama po si Karen. No, kasi yung mga palaisdaan, kapag binabagyo, sa amin po napupunta yung basura. So, I'm not saying that hindi amin yung basura. Maybe some of it. That's why we continue to address it inland. You know, because I have 31 creeks and river in the city of Manila that will flow towards Manila Bay. And if there's solid materials, yun doon sa kung saan ang galing doon palang tinitira na namin. But remember, it's old. No?
Yes.
So yung probinsya at mga syudad, paano yung kanilang basura papasok sa amin, kukunin namin. The answer to your question with regard to the portion of Manila Bay na sa amin, alam mo, araw-araw kinukuha namin yan, Karen. 3.5 million na ang report sa akin ng DPS ang nakuha namin basura since July 1, 2019 as of today. Wala pa dyan yung basenko natin na araw-araw din natin nililinis. The same thing with the creek. So kukunin namin, Karen.
Yeah.
That is my job. I think morally, technically, I have to do something about the solid waste in Manila Bay portion of Manila.
Yeah.
But tama kayo. Sana naman mga kababayan ko, kapitbayan ko, kapromisya namin dyan. Oo, sundin nyo na rin yung Supreme Court. Kaya ko lang sinasabing nagpapasalamat kami, Karen, doon sa DNR. Kami dapat gumagastos yan eh. Kami, lokal. Kami dapat. E bilyong piso yan. And this is just one start. It's a start. That's why we're very excited.
Yes.
Kasi malapit na sa endgame.
Yeah.
But the thing is, you are correct.
How will you
maraming mga illegal na fish pen o cage. And saan sila dumudumi? Pagtapos silang kumain, yung pinagpispisan nila, saan nila tinatapon? Yung santubag nila, bote ng tubig nila, pag pinagpiyo, yung mga net nila, mga kawayan nila, nasa akin nila. Yesterday, Maricho Villanueva of Big Star
saw it.
But in the afternoon, napansin mo, in fairness naman to Maricho, sinabi niya, in the afternoon, nawala na.
Yeah.
Because it's a daily thing for us. It became a habit ng pamalang lungsod. So pick it up, no matter what. Mayroong basura, undeniable, but we have to pick it up. Now, at the same manner, and I hope, and now I think DNR, hopefully you're watching, also you must have a plan. Like for example, in this case, skimmer, no? Tapos siguro ang pakikisuyo ko lang, no? Para ma-audit naman tayo ng tao, no? Yung maglagay tayo ng water quality machine. Kasi binigyan nila kami dati ng AQM dito sa ginagawa nating greening of Loton. May AQM na dyan.
World Standard AQM.
Okay.
Now, para magkaroon naman ng tape ng taong bayan, totoo ba talaga malilinis yung tubig? Dapat may makina, may science na yung quality, water quality monitoring machine. Nilalagay yun sa dagat, Karen, para mabilang yung mikrobyo, like fecals and all other things. So it is very important na makiisa na rin yung neighboring LGU na yung kanilang mga illegal fish pen or kasi kawawa rin naman yung ibang mga isda. I mean, let's be honest, marami nakikinabang doon sa laot, ha? Sa laot. Kasi dito, wala ka naman makukuha dito sa amin. Puro butete lang nito dyan, eh.
Yeah, pero ang tanong ko nga is, halimbawa, Mayor, kapag may bagyo or kapag inuulan, we've seen it, no? Even in coverage, that Manila Bay actually, pag malakas talaga ang bagyo, talagang umaakyat, humahampas po yun sa Rojas Boulevard. You've seen that as well.
Yes.
So, is the location the right place to put up like a white beachfront, Monaco-like? I understand the vision. Naintindihan ko po kayo doon.
May lalagay daw silang eh. May mechanism.
Okay.
May mechanism in front of it.
Yeah, because there's been mini tsunamis in Rojas Boulevard, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's why there is a wall. That's why they created the wall. Even in Monaco, they created the wall. That is, like for example, that is also a man-made beach.
Yeah.
But it continued to be there. And the wall is there to protect the inland habitats.
Okay.
And walls in our high-risk areas by the bay all over the world are being built.
Okay. So, your vision, am I correct? Do you want people... I mean, there are many cities all over the world wherein really people swim in cities, wherein
sana.
They're in a beachfront. It seems to me that
sana.
This is where you're going. This is what you want.
Okay, I have to be honest. I did not build this.
Yeah.
The city did not build this. And we are grateful it's being built for us.
Okay.
Now, if we are going to have a beach front, white, clean, safe water, natural water, oh, thank you very much. Aba, syempre, ito matutuwa itong mga kababayan ko sa Luxon. Dati nga, di ba? By the millions of microbes, tinitira yan ang utaw. Dumudurtot sila dyan sa... Kaya sinasaway namin, di ba? No, umalis kayo dyan. Delikado yan. But if a year or two or five from now, the next generation will experience what our lolos and lolas experience in the early times of Manila, in the heyday of Manila, when Manila Bay is clean and there is beach in the area, well, siguro yun ang regalo natin sa next generation.
Okay.
Of course, maganda yun, Karen, kasi urban eh.
Okay.
Di ba? Highly urbanized, tapos bigla ka sa beach. That's a good attraction for the next gen, for the city, and the business, employment, and the people as habitants of the city.
Okay, my last question on this issue. Are you planning to talk to the stakeholders? You have different groups already putting together position papers. The last thing you need is people, frankly, might go to court and ask for a TRO. Are you planning to have a dialogue with these stakeholders?
Well, one, again, you are welcome. You are always welcome. Sabi ko nga, your opinion is as good as mine. But in a civilized world, in a civilized time, we must be guided by law and order. No? Until no illegal activities, they can continue. And those stakeholders, so-called stakeholders, who are acting in behalf of the people of Manila, welcome naman sila sa amin. No? Kakausapin naman namin sila. But I think, you might, ako laman, I am no lawyer. You might be parking in the wrong street, no? Ako, payo ko, para makuha rin ang attention nila, ang DNR, no? But they are welcome here.
Okay.
And we will hear them. Why not? Because hindi lang naman taga Maynila, in fairness naman, hindi lang naman taga Maynila, issue na taga Maynila yan. i-issue rin yan ng buong Metro Manila o buong Manila Bay. But don't make it appear, whoever their organization, no? Don't make it appear na mas pinahalagahan ninyo ang kapakanan namin kaysa pinahalagahan namin ang kapakanan namin. Okay. That is quite something different, no? Hindi kayo ang knight in shining armor. We know also that we are mga talipandas din kami in the past. That's why we are trying to correct it, and we are just very excited to benefit from it.
Okay. Now,
but we guarantee you, this is very clear. Kapag may violation ng environmental protection, may violation ng mga batas, we guarantee you. We are always certain in our own little way. We are always certain in our laws. No? Walang mahirap, walang mayaman, walang middle class. Pinatutupad namin yan. Including national government for that matter. But so far, maliwanag ang lahat. Walang panganib na nakaakma. Then, let's see ano ang mangyayari sa linis o dumi ng tubig ng Manila Bay portion of Manila.
Okay.